Hi guys, Stu here, welcome to this week's Tubers High Score Challenge. It's Sunset Riders, picked by Matt. Excellent choice, it's straight in there as my favourite game we've ever played on the Tubers High Score Challenge. It's displaced Prehistoric Isle 2, which we're up to date was my favourite. I really love this. I think it's a really good, fast, action-paced game. The graphics are gorgeous and the sound is amazing too. And it's a nice challenge as well. So anyway, on with the gameplay footage and I hope you enjoy it. Right guys, Sunset Raiders. Riders. I hope you keep calling it Raiders for some reason. Raiders would mean you're the bad guy, wouldn't it? Insert coin, start, and we go. I always go for Camano. I like Camano. Pink poncho wearing Mexican. Off he goes. This is definitely my favourite pick of all the games we've done in the Tubers High Score Challenge since I've joined, and I joined back when I did Moonwalker. I missed quite a few challenges, but I've been playing them, so I can safely say this is my favourite one that anybody's picked, even above my own, to be honest with you. I'm just going to move my mouse marker because I noticed it is outside my emulation window and I don't want to talk to the internet. But yeah, I've never played this game before. I'd heard about it, I knew about it, and I probably should have got it when I had a Mega Drive back in the day, but I never actually did for some reason. I think it came out at a time when I was losing interest in video gaming and such, because it was at an age where there was other things that took over, you know, in your teenage years. So, didn't purchase this, but I am actually eager to try the Mega Drive and Super Nintendo versions. I reckon probably Super Nintendo does a better version of the game, but I think the Mega Drive would be able to do a competent version of it as well. Probably the sound would suffer on the Mega Drive. Nice. Hands up who died on this first time as well, because I wasn't expecting the gaps in the balls. I don't know why they put an extra enemy in there, because I mean, what's he going to do? Right, Simon Greenwell. First three bosses I'm entering with him, so it's a case of take out the henches first of all. The only unpredictable ones tend to be the ones in the lower windows that appear there. Sometimes they come out both at once, and other times they come out slightly staggered. Right, this guy's a piece of piss now. He seems to have quite a lot more hits than he normally does then. Don't know why. The other thing with the shotgun as well is you can get multiple hits on the enemy by hitting them with more of the spread. With a pistol, obviously, you're dealing with a single bullet, but the pistol fires a lot faster, so the pistol gets more hits in that way. Right. Off he goes. This level I struggled with at first, but it's a memorization thing with this level. It's knowing where to come first. So I find dodging the bullets a lot harder on the horseback. So just to get to memorise where the enemy's going to come from. Like, I've got one more enemy here, then you back off for the old wagon. Now, tip with the wagon here, you kill the first guy, jump over, wait, and you get two additional enemies pop out, and then take the wagon wheel out. Otherwise you miss out on those two pink enemies. Couple of hundred points more, not great anymore, but if you get an extra place in the challenge by 200 points, then it's worthwhile doing. Right, train now. Now there used to be a blue guy who storms in from the bottom left of the second green passenger carriage, who got me quite regular, but I've sussed the bugger out now. So he shouldn't get me. But now that I've said that, of course, it's gonna cap my arse, isn't it? Here it comes now, actually. Oh, I missed him! I did get him, but I missed him. I normally take him out before he has his chance to fight. But we got him. We got him. I think this came out in 91 in the arcade as well. I mean, for a 91 arcade game, this is rather impressive as well. Just guys low down here now. Right, the boss Triple H can be a little twat if he cuts the screen in half. And I don't like it when he jumps down as well, because you'd know, no way of knowing if he's going to take one or two hits to kill. Because if you hit him more up top before he actually jumps down, you only need to take one hit to kill him. But sometimes he needs two, and he gets a chance to get a bullet on it, bullet off at close range, which can take you out. But the key to it is to stay central so he doesn't cut the screen in half. And not a lot of people use that slide. I've not seen anybody use it as in their runs. I'm not sure people are aware of it, but it's quite an important move. There you go, you only took one hit there. Sometimes he dicks around at the top when he reaches a certain level of redness and then he jumps down, but sometimes he dicks around at the top and stays there a little bit longer so you can get an extra few shots in on him, which reduces him down to one hit and the lower tier. Right. Now this, I look dead ahead in the middle of the screen. I don't even focus on the enemies, I just react to what I'm seeing out the corner of my vision. Something I've always done with reaction tests like this, because I find if your eyes are darting down the screen, you can't react fast enough. But now I'm able to see the whole screen, but just out the corner of my eyes, basically. And it generally works. Fucking get in! That is the first time I've got all them. Get in. Get the fuck in. Whoa! Getting chuffed about that. Best of the time with 48. Jesus, that's put me in a really good spot now. Oh, I hope I can get as far as I know I can get now, otherwise that'll be worth nothing. I won't get the points from the bosses to give me my score, basically. You know what I mean, you get the big bonus points for killing the bosses, don't you, at the end. Compose yourself. Compose yourself, no silly mistakes, no dumbass mistakes. Like that. Why did he fail? I actually spotted something on that last run of the bonus round. I'm not sure if it's going to be right or not, but it looked if. That doesn't normally happen either. I normally take her out before she throws, and he doesn't get one bullet off, let alone two, so. They can piss off. Right, I like to try and take all the enemies out before I go in the saloon door, so I don't get a bullet in the arse on the way out, even though you do have a bit of invulnerability. This bit I can die on. It's all a bit random sometimes where one of the enemies stands, and if he stands in a certain spot, which he hasn't done this time. Die from the left, where are you? Oh, I got him, we didn't die off screen though. Oh, I so hope I can get to the point where I can get to before. this isn't my top run, I'm going to include that bonus round in extra footage, because... Right, crazy horse. Dark horse. This guy is easy. You just stand there and just don't move straight away. Take your time, and then you can't move his gun fast enough to focus back in on you, and you're dead already.
Me and deep big trouble.
Right, Smith Brothers, aka in a clusterfuck. These I can beat sometimes in A life, single life, or they can take all my lives. These are really, really tricky to predict what they're going to do. And the chandelier screws you over quite a bit as well, because sometimes when you think you're going to jump onto the chandelier, you actually miss it, so... Right, so we'll start by blasting a bit of the sign. Right, we'll get the invulnerability from here. You get a few seconds of invulnerability now, which you need to take advantage of. You should be dead now. Right, we'll get a bit of invulnerability again from picking this woman up. Oh, didn't mean to fall down, not a mistake. So I missed out on a few shots on there. But it's plain sailing now. Just keep moving backwards and forwards, and he can't lock in on you. Shame you can't pick that other woman up, because there's points there, but I suppose it's just in case you go for the left one first. Right, well, I can safely say this is my top score to this point so far, because I don't normally have that whopping bonus from me, from the old bonus round. Oh, I so hope I can get... Oh. Oh, dear. Right. This is another short level which you can easily fuck up on, and the boss as well is a bit of a hit and miss affair, really. I should be able to kill him with the amount of lives I've got regardless, but it just sometimes can be annoying. Right, watch out for that bomb. There we go. And the other thing that kept catching me out early doors on this level was the bomb that blows up the carriage that separates the train. I used to just plow ahead knowing that it was going to blow up, and I forgot the actual explosion blowing the carriages up actually can kill you as well. So, like here it is now, I used to just run straight ahead knowing it was going to explode and touch the explosion basically and get killed. There's another bomb that gets thrown somewhere here. Can't think where now. Ah, yeah, it's here. There it is. Another area where the slide comes in handy here, because if you just kneel down, you're obviously a sitting target then, while you're waiting for the bloody thing to go by, whatever it is, telegraph pole. Shit. Oh shit. Another enemy up here? No, boss. Right. Now with Kamano, if I kill this guy, I nick his poncho. He's not his enemy's poncho, it's Sombrero. It's the only character who does it. Duck. Oh, this is just a trouble. Yeah, I knew we were going to get a whip off and I bolted it up. And he's dead. There you go. If you don't place Kamano, the Sombrero just gets chucked off the train. I can get to this guy with the pistol, but I think the pistol is just so hard to hit hit enemies with. Right, second boss stage. Look at all those lives. Believe me, I won't have them long on the next level. The next level is a twat. Can I do it again? Can I do it again? I'm normally around the 44 mark. I don't normally get 50. Go 48. That's still good. That's like joint second best score there. This level is horrible. There's two points in it where, well, not counting the boss, the boss is horrendous, but there's two points in it where you've got a storm. Well, the first one's coming up here now, but that bit, you've got to literally move so quick to get over that rock, otherwise they pin you down and you can't advance, and it's going to happen again here now. this is going, oh, this is going too well. This guy's, I've normally lost a couple of lives on this level by now. I shouldn't die now on this level until I get to the boss, and the boss is like going to take all my lives off me. Oh, this is squeaky bum time, this guys. This is definitely squeaky bum time. Oh shit. Now there is actually an extra life I can pick up here as well. I don't know if I can get any more lives because the life meter is full, isn't it? I thought it says 5. Right. This guy is a nightmare, but I have got more lives than I ever have at this stage. Not really, I hate your guts. I hate this guy's guts. Fuck, there we go, wait, right. Concentrate. Oh, I jumped to the slid. Shit. Oh. How did he not kill me then? Now this guy's a red Indian, but fucking come on, how much more red do you want to flash? Fucking hell. That's the second time I've ever killed him, and the last time I killed him I had one life left. I'm fucking shaking here. Power ups. Of power, please. I'm not fucking tapping the button anymore. need to spread, I want to spread. This is already my top score. And... oh, God. There it is, there it is, there it is. Oh. Right, I died round about this point before. There's two blue guys that come up and screw you over. Oh, three blue guys, shit! Oh no, I see, I don't know what's coming now, you see, I'm completely flying blind, as it were. I think we're the boss. No clue what this guy does, so there's a guy there, normal guy there. He's a big fat bugger. Okay. Oh!
Please continue.
Right. I'm happy. I can die happy now. But 324,338 and the perfect bonus round. That's, yeah. Oh, I'm chuffed about that. That's good. Here we go, guys. 324,330 points. Thanks for watching. I really enjoyed that. Hope you guys do too. And look forward to the highlights on the Friday after the challenge ends. Thanks for watching, guys.